I suspect I might have got into dentistry partly through my mother. My mother was trained as a hygienist pre-World War II, about 1937. And the idea was that these girls who were trained thanks to an American millionaire's money were going to go into very, very poor houses in the East End of London, in Hackney, and try and take a dental health message to the people who lived in those houses. And she used to say to me, you try giving dental health education when the nearest tap is three floors away and they can't afford to buy toothbrushes, let alone toothpaste. So I suspect that was an influence. And the other thing that was an influence is terribly hackneyed. I've always loved using my hands, so I'd rather looked around for something to use my hands. My school friends were astonished when I said I was going to be a dentist. They couldn't understand it. They said, but surely you're going to be a teacher. And what eventually happened was I taught dentistry. So there we go. There is a lot of caries in children in UK. It's concentrated in socially deprived communities. As are many other illnesses, obesity, heart disease, all sorts, diabetes, all sorts of illnesses are concentrated in socially deprived communities. Funnily enough, I suspect the problem, or one of the problems, is that the babies don't get to the dentist. They never get there because they're never taken there until it's far too late, until they've got caries, teeth and pain, and then the child comes into dentistry with extractions, the diet is established and the diet is wrong, there's no tooth cleaning. So I think, strangely, my mother's approach of going out to them rather than waiting for them to come to her might be a way of doing it. Also, when we have babies, we're all in groups of other young mothers. That's a great time to go and talk to people about health.
Yeah.